Hello guys and welcome to my channel. My name is Jesper Offersen and today we are going to talk about azelaic acid again because we have already spoken about azelaic acid as such when we were reviewing this product here from Paula’s. Choice. And this one here is a 10% azelaic acid, but today we are going to talk a little bit more about where you can also use a product like this, or rather a product like this, because this is the one here from The Ordinary that we will be focusing on in this review here. So there are other places on the body where you can use a product like an azelaic acid, and you don't only need to use it on your face, because it could actually be that you don't have any problems on your face as such, but on your upper arms, for example, you have some issues there. And we will be talking a little bit more about that later in the review here. So if we are just to begin with looking at the one from The Ordinary, and then we are comparing it to the one from Paula’s Choice, then there are some very obvious things that you will notice straight away, because when you look at the price tag, then you might be a little bit baffled about the price for this one here, because that is very much more expensive than this one here. And yes, we know that The Ordinary, they are known for making cheap products, and I would say Paula’s Choice, they are maybe not that well for known for doing that, or not in my opinion. If you are looking at this one here, which is a travel version, it is only 5 milliliters, and that is the one I bought because I wanted to test it. And when I saw the price tag on the one for 30 milliliters, I was a little bit, thank heaven that they have this one here that is only 5 milliliters, because it is, as I said, very much more expensive. And actually, is it so that if you are taking this one here from The Ordinary, where you are getting 30 milliliters, then it will cost you much less than this one here, which there are only 5 milliliters in. And if you look at the one for 30 milliliters from Paula’s Choice, it is very much more expensive than this one here. And basically what these two products they do, they are basically just delivering 10% of azelaic acid. Yes, I do know that this one here from Paula’s Choice, it also contains salicylic acid. And there I would say that is maybe not a great thing if you are bargaining on using something like this, like every day, because you should not use salicylic acid every day. And why should you not do that? Well, because it is a proven hormone disruptor. So that is something you would not like to have on your skin more than necessary, day in and day out and so on. It is bad enough that we can't really escape them if you are using a sunscreen that is a chemical sunscreen. So there is no need to add even more to your skincare regime, in my opinion. So when we have this one here from The Ordinary, it does not contain salicylic acid. But what is the difference between salicylic acid and azelaic acid? Well, they are basically doing the same thing. But something like The Ordinary, the azelaic acid and azelaic acid in general, that is also something you can use in order to fade if you have a scar left over from a zit or a pimple or something like that, and it has discolorated your skin where it was, so it kind of like left a mark. Then azelaic acid is something you can use in order to fade such scars, so discolored scars. So that is not what we are going to talk about today, because I don't have any experience with that sort of issue. I just know that when you read about it, that is something that people are saying that it is good for, but it's not something you can use in general if you would like to, in a controversial way, want to lighten your skin in general. That is not what it is for. This is more for kind of like fading discolorations here and there. So not kind of like changing the color that you are born with, which there is really no need to do. So if we look at the ingredients on these two products, so the one from The Ordinary and the one from Paula’s Choice, then there is an ingredient in it that you might not like, or you might like it. It kind of like depends on, there are some people like it, some people don't like it. And that is a dimeticone. So it is a silicone product here. And it is a silicone suspension, if you like. And what it means is that it gives this sort of powdery feel when you are putting it on the skin. And then you might know it from hand cream and stuff like that. It gives this sort of feel of having a glove on your hands. So there are people that are saying that it will clog your pores, and there are people that are saying it will not clog your pores. But what it will do is that it will actually keep in moisture in your skin. So it will help with the skin barrier, so kind of like the moisture barrier. So it will keep in the moisture better than if you are not using the product. So it has this sort of a feel, sort of a powdery feel on the skin. So it looks like this, and it doesn't really have a smell. It kind of like maybe a little bit of a chemical smell, but you are not using a product like this in order to get a nice smell on your skin or a nice perfume. So if we are just looking at this one here, you take it out and you have this sort of a white blob, and I can just put it on my skin. So put it on here. I would say it has this sort of kind of like a mattifying effect, but it's not something that you would use in order to gain some sort of mattifying effect. You would use this in order to make sure that any of your pores will not clog up. So if you have issues with keratosis pilaris, then you can use it on your upper arms where you are usually having the issue, also called the chicken skin. And I would say a little goes a long way. This is a 10% solution, so I would say you don't need that much. And if you just put it on exactly where you are having the issue, then you will save some cost there, instead of just adding it completely all over your face or all over the entire arm, unless you have issues all over that arm. So I just put stuff on here just to get rid of it, and it has this sort of powdery sort of a feel from the dimeticone. So if you are having some issues with the keratosis pilaris, and that is why you are going to use azelaic acid, then I will say you need to do a little bit more, and that is to do something from the inside. And I will make another video later on how you can actually stimulate your skin to produce ceramide, which is something that will help your skin retain moisture, and it will help your pores kind of like not clog up. So basically what it will do if you're having enough ceramide on your skin is that you will have a much more moistened skin. So I have spoken a little bit about that before with the lactic acid and how that stimulates the production of ceramides, but there are other things you can do from the inside in order to make sure that your body is producing a lot of ceramides. So that will be in an upcoming video. So I would say you have this sort of non-greasy feel, and maybe you can see that I am a little bit more less shiny on this area than on this side here. So why did I want to make this video here? Well, first of all, I would just say that if you really need azelaic acid, I would say that this product here from The Ordinary is just as good as this very expensive one from Paula’s Choice. And another thing I would say is that often people, they are using this on their faces, maybe on their neck, and they are maybe daring to use it on their upper arms. And usually when you're having a product like this that is very expensive, then you would kind of like stop there, because it is rather expensive to use it all over your body, and maybe you shouldn't use it all over your body. But I will say there are areas on your body where this is a really good thing. And if you are sitting down every day, you know what sort of area that I am talking about. So if you are going to the beach and you are having some sort of a revealing outfit on, then maybe if you are lying there, you would like your bum to look a little bit better than if no one is looking at it. And there I will say a product like this comes in very, very handy, both because you need maybe some people will need a lot, others will not need that much. It kind of like depends on how you look. But I would say that this one here is so cheap that you can actually afford to use it on a larger area. And there could also be some people that are having not just issues on the bum, but kind of like issues further down at the backside of your thighs, because that is basically where you are sitting all day long, or most people, they are sitting down for most of the day. So there you tend to be a little bit more dry, and you have more kind of like ingrown hairs and stuff like that. And yes, you can exfoliate that area as well, but if you are over exfoliating an area, then you might end up having a very dry area. So yes, I would say something like Azelaic acid, a little goes a long way, and I would say it is really effective both on your upper arms and on your butt and on your face. But there you are going to use rather a lot if you're both using it on your face, your upper arms, your thighs and your butt and so on. So a product like this from The Ordinary, I would say that is really a great thing, because it doesn't cost that much. And something like this will be way too expensive. And in my opinion, there might be people that are not bothered about that, but as a principle, I would say that why should you pay a lot for this when you can get exactly the same effect from a product like this here from The Ordinary. And no, this is not sponsored. I am not asked to say anything of what I am saying here. So I would just say that a good tip to if you would like a smooth bum, then Azelaic acid is your friend. So yes, as always, don't overdo a thing. Always test it out on a small area of skin and see how you react. And if you are thinking or feeling that your skin is becoming too dry, or 10% is too much, then you can always add a little bit of moisturizer first, and then add the Azelaic acid on top of there, and then you can add a moisturizer on top again to kind of like make a sandwich. So yes, this I would say is something that will help with declogging pores. So if you like more of this sort of videos, please subscribe, hit the bell, and do other things. Most do not to be notified when I upload more of this sort of videos. Thank you for watching. See you. Bye.